Victoria's ever-growing inland sea is threatening to engulf new towns tonight. Dimboola to the southwest is now in danger, while Kerrang to the north remains isolated. And 10's Christopher Still is there.
Well, Kerrang seems to be lurching from one crisis to another. While the Loddon River behind me has started to fall, a creek on the other side of town has started to rise. It's expected to peak tomorrow, again threatening Kerrang. The town remains largely cut off, but outside its protective ring of levees and sandbags, things are even worse. There are fears hundreds of homes in the area could have been flooded. 10 reporter Raquel Eberly has the details.
Kerrang is a town on edge. While the levee may be holding, it remains cut off from the world. The last road out has been swamped, yet some are still trying to get through.
If you've got to go and help a mate, you've got to go help a mate.
A power substation remains a threat, but hours of sandbagging has so far paid off. Those who've refused to leave their homes forming the first and last lines of defence.
We are very confident the town itself is not under any threat whatsoever.
Residents who did flee have been offered somewhere dry at border town relief centres.
People here have been just wonderful. Couldn't have asked for anything more.
At Dimboola, the primary concern remains the town's 50-year-old weir.
Structural engineers are looking at the weir. This afternoon.
The water was expected to peak overnight, but has been steadily rising throughout the day.
Well, I've been here 50 years and I didn't expect anything like this.
And she's not alone. Ambulance services established a war-style clinic in devastated Charlton after local medical facilities were flooded. But the hardest-hit farming land will require help well into the future. Raquel Eberly, 10 News.